各位同学大家好，今天我们要介绍一下第一章记述文的第二个部分。我们会介绍三篇记述文的范本。第一篇的题目叫做 The Most Embarrassing Moment， 第二篇的题目叫做 A Special Encounter， 第三篇的题目呢叫做 A Hard Decision。 好，我们先来看一下第一篇。我们帮每一篇文章做了 GO 图，包括了介绍段，就是介绍说明主旨，然后有主体段，就是按照时间顺序把这个事件说得很清楚。再来就是结论段，重述主旨句。看一下，主旨句主要是用来表达作者对于这个事件或经验的态度或者是感觉。这个主旨句是怎么样写的？ I'll never forget the moment I became speechless in the middle of my presentation and didn't know what to do. 我永远都无法忘记在我做口头报告的时候呢，忘词，以至于不知道该怎么做。像这样一句话，就把尴尬事件的整个的重点都说出来了。接下来，我们还会介绍一下他的人物、时间、地点跟事件的背景资料。During my second year of senior high school, our English teacher asked us to give a presentation to introduce Taiwan. We had to deliver our presentations in front of the whole class. 在我高中二年级的时候，老师要我们去做口头报告介绍台湾，我们必须要在全班的面前做报告。在这里呢，把时间场合要做些什么都讲得很清楚。接下来我们就要写主体段，用六点来说明事情发展的经过。第一点呢，是得知要做口头报告的时候充满恐慌。When our teacher first made the announcement that we would have to give the presentation, I was filled with a feeling of dread and panic. 老师一宣布要做口头报告的时候呢，我感觉到害怕跟恐慌。第二点，之后想到这件事就很焦虑。Later, whenever I thought of going up in front of the class and doing the report, I felt even more and more anxious and distressed.以后一想到这件事情之后呢，就会感觉到越来越焦虑跟沮丧。好，我们再来看，当天报告的声音很小，前排学生根本就听不到，很不耐烦。Then the judgment day finally came. When I went to the front of the class, I began my speech in a low voice. Soon afterwards, I could see the students in the front row getting impatient.Because they couldn't figure out what I was saying. 审判日到来了，他上台讲的时候呢，声音很小，以至于前排同学呢显得很不耐烦，因为他们听不清楚我在讲什么。老师打岔之后呢，就忘词了，脑筋一片空白。Finally, the teacher interrupted. She asked me to speak louder. Then I forgot my lines. I mean, I went completely blank. I had memorized my entire speech.But at that moment, I couldn't even remember a single word to say. 接下来老师打岔，结果就忘词了。I went completely blank, 脑筋一片空白。之前我把所有讲稿都背下来了，但是那个时候呢，我一个字都想不出来。汗如雨下，全身湿透，崩溃哭泣。Beads of sweat started rolling down my face, and I was soon soaking wet. I just stood there, not knowing what to do next.Then I broke down and started to cry. 汗珠就流下来了，整个身体都湿透了。我站在那边不晓得怎么办，我就崩溃了，然后开始哭起来。最后我们就要写结论了。It was definitely the most embarrassing moment I've ever had. 这个是作者的一个感想，是他这一辈子里面最尴尬的一刻。好，我们来看第二篇文章 A Special Encounter。同样的，我们会有一个 GO 图告诉大家，在介绍段里面要必须要说明这个背景，而且必须要介绍你的主旨句。在主体段的时候呢，我们按照时间顺序来讲述发生的事情，然后在结论段的时候呢，我们要重述主旨句。好，我们先来看在介绍段的时候怎么来写主旨句。 At the concert, I had a special encounter with an American, and it made me appreciate the unifying power of music.在音乐会的时候呢，跟一个美国人有邂逅的经验。那这件事情呢，使得我很珍惜音乐能够结合人们的力量。他把文章整个主旨都说得很清楚了。背景我们也看一下。Last month, I went to Jay Joe's concert alone. 介绍背景很简单。上个月，我独自去参加周杰伦的演唱会。好，我们接下来就要写主体段。我们先写在演唱会开始前两个人相遇的过程，包括他的地点、时间、人物、互动的细节。 I arrived at the concert venue and sat down 15 minutes before it started. While I was watching a music video on the screen before the concert began, a white girl came and sat next to me. She was of average height and had curly blonde hair. I politely smiled at her and she smiled back. Soon we started a conversation. Because I was by no means proficient in English, we used a lot of body language and gestures to communicate, and we hit it off right away. 这一段蛮长的，讲述在音乐会之前呢所发生的，遇到了这样子的一个美国女孩，描述女孩长得什么样子，然后她先开始向这个女孩微笑，那女孩也跟着向她微笑，他们就开始聊天了。因为她的英文能力并不是非常好，所以他们用很多的肢体语言来沟通，但是呢，他们很投缘。这里 hit it off 就是很投缘的意思。好，我们接下来看演唱会开始之前两人交流的过程，谈论从哪里来的，为什么喜欢周杰伦。She was also a big fan of Jerry Joe, and she had flown all the way from Los Angeles to watch his concert. When we were chatting about Jerry Joe's songs, she said she was inspired by the variety of his lyrics and melodies. She was also crazy about his cool looks.
两个人都是大粉丝，这个美国朋友呢是从洛杉矶来的，专程跑来看周杰伦的音乐会，他因为周杰伦的歌词跟旋律的多样性而受到启发，同时他也因为周杰伦的很酷的外观而被吸引。
好，我们再来看演唱会开始之后呢，他体会到音乐结合的力量，因为两个人一起唱歌享受美丽的歌曲，同时两个人陌生人之间没有任何隔阂。
After the concert began, we sang and enjoyed the beautiful songs together. In the middle of the concert, it occurred to me that there was no barrier between us, two strangers who had different cultural backgrounds and spoke different mother tongues. At those moments we shared with each other, the music united us regardless of all our differences.
音乐会开始之后，我们就一起跟着唱，来享受这美好的旋律。但是在演唱会中间的时候呢，他突然想到了，我们是两个陌生人，有不同的文化背景，使用的是不同的母语，但是好像没有任何隔阂，而且在那些共享的时刻里面，音乐把我们结合在一起，虽然我们有很多不同的地方，这一段可能是最重要的一个部分了。好，我们最后来看结论怎么写。
I can't believe I've made a friend from another country through music.
我无法想象我基于音乐和别的国家的人交朋友，把他的主旨又重说了一遍，表达出作者对这件事情的看法。好，最后我们来看 A Hard Decision 介绍段，先要介绍主旨，同时要说明背景，然后我们有主体段，主体段呢也是按照时间顺序来说明这个事件的经过，提出问题，最后把问题解决了。在结论段的时候呢，重述主旨句，不过这一篇写法比较特别，我们等会来一起来看。
I remember clearly the day when I made a hard decision after I saw my classmates cheating on a test.
一开始开宗明义就把这个事情说得很清楚了。我记得很清楚那一天同学作弊，我必须做一个很困难的决定。
It happened when I was in 8th grade. Our math teacher was a hard-working middle-aged man, and he often gave us a test in class to find out whether we understood the lessons.
发生的时间是在他八年级的时候，数学老师很认真，通常给我们考试来了解我们是否懂得这些课业。接下来我们来看主体段的部分。首先呢，考试的时候发现两位同学作弊，那英文怎么写呢？
One day, while I was taking a math test, I sensed that something strange was going on with the two classmates in front of me. One was discreetly copying answers from the other.I felt confused because it was the first time that I had seen people cheating on a test.
有一天，我在考试的时候看到前面两个同学好像有点不太对劲，一个人站在小心翼翼的去抄另外一个人的答案，我觉得很困惑，因为这是我第一次看到别人在考试作弊，所以先把这个背景的情况先说明了。次日拿到成绩，两个人都考得很好。
The next day, we were given our test results.I was curious about how the two had done on the test. It turned out that they had both done very well.
第二天发成绩，我很好奇他们考得怎么样。结果呢，他们两个都考得非常好。这里他用的是一个过去完成式，因为先发生的时候我们有过去完成式。 接下来呢，作者就陷入两难之境，因为他觉得应该要告诉老师，可是又怕别人说他打小报告。
I felt I should tell the teacher that they had cheated, but I didn't want to be a snitch. This put me in a dilemma. If I told on these two classmates, what would others think of me? But if I didn't, then maybe other honor students would also start cheating so that they could have better grades than the others.
他陷入两难之境，一方面呢，他觉得应该告诉老师，但是他又不想做一个抓耙子 snitch 打小报告的人。 Dilemma 就是两难之境。 If I told on, tell on 就是去打小报告的意思。那这个 tell on 是动词， snitch 是个名词。如果打小报告，其他同学会怎么看我？但是如果不告诉老师的话，那其他的这些比较诚实的同学呢，也会想要作弊，因为他们想要拿到更好的成绩，所以他觉得很难做这个决定。最后他做了困难的决定。
Making this hard decision tortured me for days.
我煎熬了好几天才做了这个痛苦的决定。那我们看结论怎么写了。一般我们是要重申主旨句，并表达作者对于这个事件或经验的回想或学到的教训。但是在这里呢，我们看到他写的很简单。
A few days later, I went into the teacher's office and did what I thought was the right thing.
他并没有重述主旨句，只是告诉读者说，几天之后呢，我到老师的办公室，做了我该做的事情。那我们从上下文看起来，他就是去告诉老师了。这种写法呢，就是很技巧的把文章结束。好，我们总结一下写记叙文的几个要点。第一个呢，它的组织架构，我们有介绍段、主体段跟结论段，每一段都有它的基本的功能。同时我们要按照时间的先后顺序来写，尽量利用感官细节来详细的描绘，才会比较生动。注意主旨句跟结论句如果写得好的话，有画龙点睛之妙，就是让读者很容易去了解你这篇文章要表达的是什么。最好是能够写的让读者能够感同身受，好像他们也经验过同样的事情。好，我们对于记叙文的介绍就到这里结束。下一章节我们就要介绍描述文。